side, baby. Come on, come on.
What up, y'all? It's your girl, Me Quiet, and I'm live from Ghetto Granite with my boy Jack, Jiggy Jack, from G Side.
Yes.
So you got a new album coming out. Why don't you just let everybody know who is Jack?
Crazy. Complex. I mean, not the Jack that everybody knew back in the past. It's another different type of Jack that's on a whole new vibe, doing some whole new stuff.
Why don't you explain the theory behind your new music that you got, since you changed it?
Well, the theory behind my music is a more, you're going to have to think with listening to me now. I mean, back in the day, I told you stuff that made you just buck wild and wild out. Now, I'm saying some things that's going to make you think. It's still hard, still sick, still dope, but it's still, you know.
It's on another different
vibe. Right, it's on another vibe. You got to think.
How long have you been rapping?
About 11, 12 years.
Wow, that's a long time.
Yeah, a long time. So I know the ins and outs about, you know, how to do my craft, how to put it down. So it's nothing new.
Right.
Okay.
Who are some of your idols in the rap game?
Well, idols, I don't have that. You know, I wouldn't say I got no idols. There's some people, you know, nowadays the game's so messed up out here.
Right.
You know, I can't say who my favorite is or who I listen to or none of that. I just still go with the ones who started me off, like the LL Cool J's and the Run DMC's and that kind of stuff. But as far as the idol, no, I don't, because I just do me.
Okay, so I'm in the club. I'm going to ask you a question that everybody probably want to know.
What's that?
Why did you take a leave from rap?
Plain and simple, I had to get my mind right. When I was in the game back before, I did more drinking and drugs than music, you know what I mean? And so I had to leave the game, pause, look at my life and say, hey, what you want to do with it? Where you want to go? Because, you know, I was doing it. I was in the game real heavy. You know, as everybody know, I've been signed with Too Short, and that really just took me downhill. You know, not in a bad sense, you know, to spit on him or nothing, because that's my man, but I just went downhill on a personal level for me.
Right.
So I had to, you know, regroup and get myself back together and come back and do what I know how to do.
Do a little growing. Of your work and you as
an
artist?
A lot of people might think that this is, you know, the page that I'm on now, what I'm doing could be like a gimmick or a fad or whatever they may think. I don't know, but I know in my heart and the places I've been and the walk that I walked and the road that I'm on that, hey, I just want to see and make a difference. I don't want to live my whole life telling people some crazy demented and twisted issues and things like that and just die. It's more to life than that. I want to be able to leave some type of legacy to where, hey, this brother, you know, changed his ways, changed his life, and he tried to help somebody. That's, you know, if that's the whole, in a nutshell, if that's all I do, I'm good.
What about, what's your take on rap music?
Well, my take on rap music, there's some good rap music out there, but, you know, the powers make it be that you have to search so hard for what they put on us ain't exactly what everybody like to do and what everybody like to hear. I mean, to party and every now and then, you know, it's good. You know, somebody like to, you know, want to get some stress out, so they want to go to the club, they want to do this, but every day, all day, come on, man. How many people can you kill? How many drugs can you sell or smoke or whatever? But we, you know, what we trying to do now, you know, and I ain't trying to be so hard down on the artist that's out here now, but I just wanted to say that, come on, y'all gotta do a better job of being responsible for what you're putting out here. You know, because you got kids, you got everybody that's trying to mimic what you're doing. And a lot of people say that it's only entertainment. No, it's not. It's entertainment to you.
Right.
But to the youth and the public, they trying to copy the things that you say. Look at everybody when you say Air Force One.
Everybody
running out there. Stopped the Air Force One hopped up, didn't it?
Yeah.
So I'm just saying, we got to be more responsible in some of the things that we putting out here to the public.
We drink blood.
Take flesh.
You want to achieve with this album?
Well, I just want to show growth and change.
Right.
And, you know, the game right now is one-sided. Everybody is saying one particular thing and sending out one particular message. Well, I want to be the opposing force. I want to give them something else. And they can say, hey, I don't have to listen to this all the time. I don't have to drive like this, you know. And plus, every age or gender or whatever can get into what I'm doing now. You know what I'm saying? There's no cutoff limit for what I'm doing. You know, I'm priding myself with people from the age of 12, 5 or all the way up to the age of 60 is like, hey, I love this album, I like what you're saying. And, you know, that mean a lot to me, and I appreciate that, that people is digging my work.
That's good, because there's so much music right now that's sending the wrong message to everybody, so right. Saying yours is like...
Right. And a lot of people that send these messages don't believe what they're saying, you know, because I was there too, you know, and it's what the industry dictates, you know what I'm saying? If you want to get on it, you want to do it, and do it this, you got to do it this way, not so. I'm just, you know, I'm showing you another way to go.
If there was anything that you could change right now at this moment in your life, what would that be?
In my life, well, I got issues.
A bunch of
issues. So, yeah, we can't even go there.